Oh, hi, it's JT, Indian River County fluid artist, and it's late at night, and it's really late, actually, it's almost 1, and I'm still at it. So we're going to go ahead, and we're going to try this, and I'll walk you through it, and we'll see if it works out. Everything is an experiment when I do art. So let me put you down and let you see what's going on. Okay, on this canvas here, I have blue, red, and yellow. Primary colors, this is a re-pour. You can see the old canvas underneath. We really don't have to worry about too much here, except for, there is something right here. I don't know what that is, but we're taking it out. Looks like it was a clump of blue. Okay, so that's going out, and the knife's going back into its proper place. And I'm going to take my, you can do this with your finger. I'm just taking a chopstick and doing it. And I'm just running everything together. Okay, there should be, wait, I got another clump here. There should be more than enough paint on the canvas, but I'm gonna be absolutely positive. So I'm gonna actually pour a little gold around here and a little white. And I'll let you see as I go. I'm not certain that I have this. Okay, I don't want you falling in the paint. That would be disastrous. Okay, so I have some gold. I'll go ahead and pour that around. I think gold is like a brilliant color. I love gold. And I'm just going to do a clean pour around here. This actually is what's known as a clean pour because none of these colors are mixed. They're going to mix on a canvas when I move it. And this is a one time that you're like, okay, you can really move your canvas, which is like, and so whether they're created or not, well, hopefully they'll be created. I mean, that's the goal, but a pretty picture is better than anything. Okay, I'm just hitting the corners because I have fear about corners not getting done. I always have fears about my corners, so I just hit the corners just in case, you know, just in case they're not gonna get hit. So let me, now I'm actually going to have to get up and change positions to move this canvas around. So, I can put a little white in here too. A little, you know, targeted white. It won't hurt anything. And make certain that we're really covered. You know, because nothing is worse than having too little paint on your canvas. I mean, it becomes, to do a re-pour is such a pain, and it doesn't look right unless it's planned in advance. And this one is not planned to be a re-pour. So, I don't even know if it's going to turn out to be total junk, but I'm going to get over here and I'm going to move, and I'm going to start moving the canvas around so I don't fall on it, which would make a really great video, and we'll see if we get anything. I mean, that's really the goal here. So we start moving it to cover the canvas, get it all covered, and see if we get any kind of cells or anything really cool. I'm losing a lot of red. I'm gonna flip it up. Hold on, guys. You're not gonna see this, but I have to flip it at this point. Kind of. You guys are kind of, sort of. Let me turn it so you guys can see it. You guys are kind of, sort of not gonna be able to see what I'm doing. I'm actually gonna try and move the paint in this direction. And see if we can cover. We're not going to get the pretty sauce that we normally get. Which is, it's okay. I mean, for what this painting is, it's really not supposed to be. Well, it can be cellular, but more we're mixing paint on the canvas. Which makes the paint really. Kind of a cool concept. Okay. So here we have like this psychedelic. Wait a minute, I got one spot left to cover. So I can actually do that with my finger. And this needs to be covered too. I mean, you don't let your. One of the things I guess I should talk about is that your edges, your sides, should always be covered. And that's a professional thing, that you don't let your sides go uncovered because of the fact that, people like to hang these without frames. Now, I don't feel either way about it. I have some of mine in frames and I have some of mine not in frames. So, I mean, to say that they belong in frames is kind of hypocritical because of the fact that I have some that are not in frames. However, and some that are in frames that people really like. And I get a lot of compliments on these. I don't know, guys. I haven't heated it up. So let me reach over and grab the torch. Oops. Again, you guys almost got nailed. Drag in the torch. And let me see if I can bring any cells up. There's supposedly a way you can make cells after the fact. I haven't learned that yet. So I can't teach you about anything I don't know. But let's see if we get cells coming up with the torch. Which there should be because there's silicone in here. And see, I'm seeing some cells coming up. These cells would not have come out without the torch. That's why whenever I talk about supplies with people, I always talk about the torch. Because sometimes you're just not going to get cells unless you torch. And they're big cells. You just can't see them without the torch. We've got some really good cells up here. I wouldn't have thought, based on how the painting looked, after, you know, we tipped it and did whatever, that we would actually have cells. I didn't see it. But then as time passed, I'm like, oh, that looks like a cell. And there, that may be a cell. You know, wait a minute, we have cells in here. So that, inspired me too. I actually really like the colors. You know when your paint is willing to bubble and flame before it'll show you a cell that you don't have, you're not in cell territory. It just isn't there. But I still shoot for it. Every time I'm looking to burn off that top layer and see what's underneath. And trust me, the cells do appear. They make their presence known. We've got a lot of cells in here that just weren't readily seen after we poured. See, we've got some really good cell activity going on here. I'm really shocked because I didn't think we had any cells going into this. And then when I added the white doesn't have any silicone in it. I thought, sure, we've got nothing. So we really ended up having some spectacular cells. So this is really a viable method. If you don't want to do a dirty cup, then you want to do a clean cup and mix on the canvas. Remember, I only did primary colors here. So when I show the final product to you, you have to remember, it was only primary colors. So the purple is really red and blue mix. We didn't get a whole lot of green, but we have some. And that's the yellow and blue. So, I mean, a lot of these colors, and I know you're probably sitting here saying, this is the most boring thing in the world, listening to the torch. Now, this is part of it. I mean, seriously, guys, if you can't torch, you really don't need to do this, because this is the game. This is where you see it. Okay. So let me take you off now and show you the final product. Okay, these are our cells that we have here. Here are more cells. I mean, we really hit a lot of cells. Cells up here. Cells over here, cells over here, there's the cells, there are the cells, I don't think I can pull back, there are more cells, and there are more cells, here is the painting at a distance, and so that's it guys, I hope you have a great night, this is J.T. Walters, Indian River County, Fluid Artist. We just did a clean pour, and we mixed on the canvas, and then we heated it up to see what we got. So, I hope you enjoyed. I will see you later. Have a good evening.